Welcome back to the Kieran Carlin Football Channel, where occasionally we cover many topics of football, but one of the major ones is visual items, visual things. And today I'm embarking on a massive, mahoosive task, which no one has ever done. Well, someone might have, but I haven't checked. Which no one has ever done before, and that is ranking. Who has a good badge in the entire football league? All 92 teams. We go from delete your club all the way up to perfect art. Now, if you are new to the channel or if you just haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to hit subscribe. I want to try and hit 20,000 supporters before the beginning of the Premier League season, which is not far away, let me tell you. So jump and click that button right now. Graphic design is my passion, and we're gonna go along with, Jesus Christ, that's a lot. We're gonna go along with the order it's in. And I believe this is last season, so please forgive me for the new Aston Villa badge, and there's no Wrexham or Notts County. But, you know, you snooze, you lose. Accrington Stanley is our first one, and it's just like, oh, it's boring. I'm going boring. It's a roundel with an old coat of arms in the middle. It's fine, inoffensive. I'm sure they like it, but it's 2023, mate. Go on. Simplify it a little bit. Next up, we've got AFC Wimbledon. The Wimbledons. I don't really understand the two-headed creature on it. It's an odd shape. It's a shield, but it's a shape of shield that feels a bit skew-iff. It's not quite like the Arsenal shape of shield, or Barnsley, or... And okay, it's pretty similar to Bournemouth, but I don't think I like that one either. So, AFC Wimbledon... I'm gonna stick it in fine. I think it's fine for them, but if it was my club, I would hate it. Arsenal. Delete it. It just does my head in, okay? Because it's just the same as the Israeli badge, the old Ireland badge. It's the most template badge ever. And I thought Arsenal was supposed to be some sort of big club. Not if you've got that as your badge. Just change it just to the cannon. You can't be having some rotund little bulgy shield like that. No. You've got a template badge, mate, because your club is tosh. Aston Villa. This is the old badge. The new one is way better. The new one is nice. And if you think it looks like Chelsea, it does. But Aston Villa had this same badge at around the same time Chelsea had their original round badge. So, you know, it's not like they haven't copied Chelsea, okay? The new badge actually looks more like Aston Villa to me, and I never saw the old one, so that's peculiar, isn't it? I'm going to put their old badge in... I'm going to put it in boring. I think it was just a bit naff. Like, how dull's that? They removed the word, like, prepared or whatever, and they updated it to even more dull. Barnsley. There's a gradient and two farmers? Or I'm going to assume farmers on it. Delete. Awful. Just awful graphic design all around. Just honky. It stinks, mate. Barnsley stinks. I've never been, to be fair, but based on the badge, it probably does stink. Barrow. Now, Barrow have a submarine. That's pretty cool. I'm going to stick it... Oh, is it nice? Graphic design-wise, it stinks, but it has a submarine. Okay, and that is cool unless you pay 250 grand to go on one and you die. So, as long as it's not one of those submarines, and it's one of the submarines which are utilised in war and kill hundreds of people, I'm okay with it. I'll stick it in nice. Birmingham City. I love it. There's not a single thing. You know what? Perfect art. It's our first perfect art. There's not a single thing I would change about the Birmingham City badge, because it's a unique shape. No one else has it. It's a football, okay? And the world loves football. Genius, absolute genius. And then it's just got, you know, like a little bit of taping. It could be a big scarf, I don't know. But it's unique and I love it. I think it is fantastic, interesting. As is Blackburn Rovers. Now, it's not only just a round badge. It's got a massive plant in the middle, a massive rose. But then it also has this cool little art et labor. At the bottom, whatever that means, I guess means art is labor. I'm going to have a guess, which is true. True art is working 15 hours a day down the mines. I just think it's a classic badge. I think there's a fantastic badge. I think it would be slightly worse off if it didn't have the bottom bit. I think the bottom bit adds so much, and I think the colours make it pop. I like it. I really do like it. Blackpool. Now, Blackpool have got the essence of a circle, but the crime of having no circle. It's very odd, and I feel like it sticks out on the shirt because it's just like the letters are just there, like floating. I'm going to put it in fine. I can't imagine. No, Blackpool should just have a massive tangerine on it. Like an actual tangerine. That's what they should have. I'll stick it in fine. Bolton, the new Bolton badge. Nice. No, I quite like it, you know. I sort of like the update they did. It's new. The ribbon is a bit sort of odd, but I'll take it. I'm pretty fond of that one. Bournemouth. Why did you bother, mate? Why did you bother? The backwards header, all right? It's growing on me, okay? It is growing on me, but you can't be having the backwards header from a corner. You know what I mean? Or just a really poor defensive header back to the goalkeeper. I'm not having it. I'm not convinced. I feel like there should be something better representative of Bournemouth and with less gradients. Bradford City. Now, there's a big old cock on this one. Is it a cock? Some sort of bird that lays eggs. I mean, they all lay eggs, but, you know, eggs that you might eat. Oh, I really hate the colour scheme of this club. Whoever chose it is a moron. I'm going to stick it in I'm going to stick it in fine. I think it's got some sort of old school about it, but not too old school that it's like, come on, mate, move on. I think it's okay. Brentford, it's got a big old B on it. I love it. Do I love it? It's pretty similar to the City badge. I know it's another round badge, but it feels relatively new and exciting. Well, not new and exciting, but a bit more current. So I prefer it to their old badge, I believe. So yeah, I'm just getting to love it. You know, I think it's nice. I think the colours pop. Brighton, it's a big old seagull. I'm going to put it in nice. It's pretty similar to the Brentford one, but I just feel it feels a little bit empty. That's all. I think with some dates added or maybe another white line in the middle might increase it into I love it territory. But for now, it's staying in nice. Bristol City, another bloody circle. Oh, this is very, I feel like they've had this one for a while, but it's pretty simplified, impressive. Can I do I love it for Brentford and not for Bristol? I'll stick it in, I love it. I think it's nice. I think it does a job. Has a date in there. I like having the date in the badge. I think it's important to prove to everyone else that you're a football club that's really old. Bristol Rovers. It's a man with a sword. Is it a pirate? Who knows? But whatever it is, he's playing ball. It's nice. It's unique. They've gone for the circle and thought, you know what, mate? Fuck it. Let's just go outside of the usual boundaries and have a massive man with a weapon. Jesus. All right. I'll stick that in nice. Burnley. Well, this is their old one. And the new one is actually much nicer, but they're still using this one. So, just terrible. Really horrible. The amount of extra space here baffles me. But the main thing is the gradient. Oh, has a black to yellow gradient ever looked good side by side with claret and just like a really desaturated blue? Fuck it out, mate. You are struggling. Brewers. What's this? Burton Albion. I like that the B and the A is inside the little fat man running about. Oh, do I? It's fine. Graphically, it's really poor. But I do love it because of the fat man. I'm going to put it in I love it. Not for graphic designs reasons, but because they put a big fat man kicking ball with a B and an A in it. It's so stupid. Cambridge United. It's a castle with a big ball and CU. It's not good. I'm going to put why did you bother? It's not good. It's like if a Sunday league team came up with a badge, or you could generate a clip art badge, that's what it would be. Really, really tragic, really unfortunate. I'm sorry. Cardiff City. Now, they had badge problems recently, in recent years, in the past 10 years, with Vincent Tan changing it to this red number and their kit to red. Turns out, I actually quite like the red badge. This one doesn't feel like it has much of an identity. I know it's got a massive bird on it. but it's boring. There's no cohesive, I don't know, it just feels a bit, doesn't feel like it has much personality, unfortunately. I feel like Cardiff deserve a better badge. I feel like someone should come up with a better badge for Cardiff. Because their previous one, before the Vincent Town one, was awful. Really was just a series of colours I despise altogether. So this one looks better than that, but there's no personality. I don't like it. Carlisle United. It's a peculiar shape which I have not seen anywhere else. I guess almost a Barcelona shape, like a squished Barcelona. And then they have the Leighton Orient badge inside it. Oh, it's okay. It's okay. I'll put it in fine. I quite like the brutality of the red and the blue next to each other, because that's just a bit odd to do. You wouldn't expect that, but there's something about it where I'm like, you know what, that's okay. But for that size of club, if you went bigger, I think that would be an issue, right? In the Premier League, I think that would be an issue to have as a badge. If you want to be like a global entity, then you're probably not having that. But if you don't want to, which is absolutely fine, by the way, that's a perfectly fine thing to not want to be. That's a good badge. So, you know, it is, well, it's a fine badge. It is what it is. Charlton Athletic, they have a gradient and they've got perfect art. Now, it might be simple, like the Brighton one, but the difference between that is it's a fucking sword. What's not to love? A weapon, yes, please. We're not only going to beat you at football, but we're gonna dice you up, mate. Beautiful. And I just think Charlton Athletic is a really fun name for a team. I don't know why, it just works. Charlton Athletic. It's just good syllables all round. Chelsea's badge. It feels pretty Chelsea. Oh, perfect art though. Yeah, I don't think you can make that Chelsea badge better. I think it, well, apart, you know, I obviously did in my video where I remade all the Premier League badges, but I don't think you can make that Chelsea badge better. I think that is what it is. I can't believe I got so many round ones up in the top bit. I thought I would get sick of them. Cheltenham. Now this is an interesting one. It's, I'll just stick it in fine. It's in, you know what, is it? It's not a football badge, but it's good sort of graphic design because this is a shield, but also some sort of bird where the front of the bird is red. Is it a robin redbreast? I don't know. Is it a seagull that has accidentally fallen into some peri-peri sauce? Who knows? Who knows? I could Google it, but that ruins the fun, doesn't it? So fine feels like a good place to put the Cheltenham badge. It's nice. You know, I was to get nice, actually. It's nice. It's a bit different. Colchester United. Now, I am from Colchester, and I don't want to be biased, but I love it. I think it is a fantastic badge. It's your average, you know, sort of Burton Albion shape badge, but I quite like the stripes incorporated in it. It's clean, it's simple, but then it's got a bit of detail with the massive eagle, or whatever bird it is. There's no eagles in Colchester, so not quite sure where we've gone for that, but I think it's a nice badge, right? I think it's like, the problem with Colchester is that they've like literally never in history had a good kit. There's like one in the 99 noughties sort of time that's a good kit. I would wear that one, right, for fun, but the rest of them have been stinking, undeserving of a pretty decent badge. Coventry City. Let's stick that in. I love it. Now, I love Coventry's badge because it's got three animals on it and a castle and a football and it's one bird on fire. It looks like one bird might be potentially on fire. And then it's got two ribbons and multiple colours. It's got, if you needed a badge that was like, you know what, mate? Let's put bloody everything on it. Coventry. I like it. And I think I just really like elephants. I love it. I think it's a good badge. Crawley Town. Now, they've decided to go for a horribly shaped shield inside just a black circle. Just so the text isn't technically floating. But it's shocking. That is a shocking bit of design. Hate it. Too much going on. Vile. It'd be like if Coventry put their badge in a circle, I'd be like, what are you doing? I would then call that rubbish. Because it's not. It's just out there. That's fine. But this would have exposed text and no, we've established that's a no-no. I mean, Blackpool got a fine, but it's still a no-no. Crewe Alexandra. I don't like the shape of the shield. The middle bit, that's cool. Maybe if you turned it into a circle, that could be cool. Maybe if you did like a Werder Bremen shape. Oh, Harumbus. Oh, yes, please. I'm going to stick this in. Why did you bother? I think the shape just feels really amateurish. Crystal Palace, fantastic. Really like it. Really like it. We've got a big bird sitting on Crystal Palace. And a little football in there, a little ribbon. And I like the design of the eagle. I think it's good. I think it's current. I think it works on a hat. I think it works on multiple merchandises. Maybe even a pencil case. Derby. Now, this is just a ram. Fine. Is it still just a ram? Oh, wow. They really do just... They just put the ram on there. You know what? I'm going to go nice. I like that. It's like Arsenal just having the cannon on their badge. Liverpool just having the liver bird on their badge. Or liver bird, sorry. Doncaster up next. Now... This is a shameless one. It's a man with a sword, already really good in my book, but I'm gonna stick it in why did you bother? Because it's so close to being good, but I just see it and I don't see a man wearing a cape. I see a moth with a human head and a sword ready for battle. And I don't want the image of a moth having an offensive tactic at me, okay? I like to be the one with the ease of a win in that scenario between the battle between me and a moth that has flown in. So I'm sorry, but that needs some alteration, and it could be a great badge. But for now, it's a moth. Everton. Oh, it's a classic. It is good. I love it. You know, I think that's a good badge. I like it. It's clean. It feels relatively symmetrical. I think maybe get rid of one of the, I think, wreaths or horseshoes. I can't see. It's quite small. But I don't really like those. But the rest of it, I'm all for. Okay, it feels nice, nicely proportioned. Exeter City, delete. I don't like it. I really don't like it. I don't like the half and half alternating colours. Then you just cramming in another half and half in the middle, and then a coat of arms. And then the crest shape is just too. It's not for me. That don't like it. The crest shape is like the end of a felt tip pen. Fleetwood Town. I don't. This is a similar half and half situation. I don't like the alternate lettering. I'm going to stick it in. Why did you bother? I don't think that's a nice badge. I don't. I'm really sorry. I feel like they're maybe not too far off, but the letters just feel placed there. They don't feel evenly spaced. You know what I mean? Forest Green. Yeah, nice. I think that's nice. I think that's an alright badge. Nothing too crazy about it, but it's got everything you need. Couple of animals, a ball, some stripes, and the green. Has it got the date? Yes, it's got the date. You don't need the FGR, but it is what it is. Fulham Football Club. It's really basic. Like, what is that? Really? It's like unfinished. It's so odd. It feels like it needs a bit more. Maybe it needs like a little ribbon at the bottom. Or maybe it should just be the Pizza Hut logo like I made. Well, I think mine's way better. Gillingham Football Club. I'm going to stick it in fine. You know, I think the top of the badge needs some work. Whereas the Gillingham Football Club feels a bit naff. The border feels a bit thin. But I like the stripes on one side and then the horse on the blue on the other. I think that's pretty decent, that. Grimsby. I hate this one. I don't know why. I just hate it. Just the red thin lines. And the shape of it is so odd. It's unique. But I just don't like it. I think it's really ugly. I'm sorry. Harrogate Town. I'm going to stick them in. Nice. It's a nice circle, but maybe you want a bit more personality. You know what I mean? It doesn't feel very personable. I think that's the issue with that one. I'm going to move that down to fine. Not personable enough. Hartlepool up next, and a bit like Blackpool, but... Oh, do I like it? Could look cool on a cap. I'm going to put fine. I might be wrong about the loose text, by the way. The loose text seems to be working, but I feel like probably good for their level. You couldn't have the loose text on like a Premier League shirt. It wouldn't work. Wouldn't work. Huddersfield. Fine. Is it fine? No, I'm going to put why'd you bother. There's just too much going on. It's a bit of a kerfuffle. But to be fair, it does feel like Huddersfield. But I feel like... There could be something better in there. You know what I mean? Hull City, delete. Awful. It's got a tiger on it, mate. I should be loving it, but the shape of the crest is a bit odd, and it just feels really like, it feels like a rugby team. You know what I mean? It just feels like a rugby team. No one likes rugby. Ipswich Town, perfect art. Horse playing football above a river. Yes, inside a castle, is it? Oh, yes, go on. Love it. Love it. I just like the colours as well. The colours go pretty well on that. They go hard, my friend. Well spaced out. Job done. All the information you need. Does it need the date of when they were formed? No, I don't think it does. Usually it would do, but I think that one gets away with it. Leeds United. It feels very Leeds, so I'm going to stick it in. I'll stick it in nice. It's okay. But if they just had like a massive white rose, that would be cool. That would be cool. Leicester City. It's good. It is good. You know, it might be perfect art. It feels very Leicester. I think it's good. It's a good round all badge. There's enough detail in it to make it interesting. I like that there's only two cars in it and the rest is white. The attention is drawn to not too many things, just those things. Next up is Leighton Orient, which previously we saw inside the Carlisle badge. It's okay. It's a bit unique. I'm going to stick it in fine. I don't mind it, you know. I don't mind it. I think it's quite cool. Two dragons and a ball. All right. Job done. Only two colours. Well, only one colour, really, and then black and white. So, you know, I'll take that. I think that's good. Oh, this ugly imp. Oh, my God. Lincoln City, is it? Yeah. Awful. Awful. It does, but it's so ugly. He's got, like, tiny legs. It looks like he has one leg. Why is he pretending to do, like, that weird street magic trick? Where when they're like, oh, look, how am I sitting? How am I floating? He's sitting on a metal bar that goes up one leg. That's all it is. Right. It's not impressive. Nor is that stupid imp. Liverpool. Now, you know what? I like it. I like it. Without the gradient on it. I don't know if it has a permanent gradient. I like it. The Justice Flames, all good. The ribbon, all good. I really like the green and red colour scheme. I think they're two colours that go really well together. And that Liverpool need to utilise way more in their kit. Just the bird is pretty cool on the actual kit. But I would like this badge to come back. You know? I'd like them to use this one again. I really like it. Luton Town. No, it's not boring. Oh, I'm going to put it in why did you bother? It's too... You know, it's fine. It's fine. It feels Luton. I think the text on the outside is actually quite good. I like the font it's in. It's nice and thick. Whereas, you know, I struggle with the Hartlepool one and the Blackpool one because the font feels quite thin. Whereas if it's floating around, you need it thick boy. And that's what they've gone for. It feels like there's maybe too much going on in the middle. There's a hat. Which just reminds me of Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. But it's fun. Manchester City. Now, this is my club. And you would expect me to be biased. But I'm actually unbiased, okay? I'm actually a great guy. I'm going to put this in. Delete your club. I'm not overcompensating, but... My problem with it is a slightly like I love it, but it's a slightly cartoonish central nature of it that is slightly like round and popping out the middle of the roundel. Ah, I don't know. It really bothers me that one little bit. It feels very City, but it still feels just that little 20% cartoonish, and it really bothers me. Really bothers me. The United badge. God, this feels wrong, but. I don't want to be putting ours down there and theirs up there, but I've had to, because I'm trying to be honest here. To be honest, I'm just not putting it in. I love it. It's them, isn't it? It looks perfectly evil enough for those bastards. What's it? Mansfield Town? Really, just horrible, horrible spacing. I'm going to put it in delete your club, mate. Really, I don't like it. Middlesbrough. Is it fine? I don't really like the shape of it. I'm going to put it in why do you bother. Don't really like the shape of it. The ribbon just comes out way too far that it's borderline looking like a moustache on the crest. I'm not a fan. Millwall. Oh, boring. Bit basic. Big line. There's just something about the Millwall colours which just don't speak to me. They're really naff. They really should just change that. MK Dons. Delete your club. It's not a real club anyway. Sorry, boys. I know every club's got to start at some point, but you were taken. Taken from somewhere else in the country and moved. Morecambe. That is disgusting. Sorry, mate. You're gone. Newport County. Well, it's got a ball in the middle, but I don't really like the little shield inside. I'll put it in why did you bother. Sorry. Northampton. Ugly. Sorry, mate, but what's going on there? The colours are just so desaturated and just naff, and there's just too much going on. Don't like it. Has that got a tusk? Got a tusk. Jesus Christ. The new Norwich badge. I like it. I think this is a great new era for the Norwich badge, as we are all, I'm sure, very fond of new Norwich eras. I know it had some blowback from the Canary community, but ultimately, an impartial view, I think it works, and I think it'll still look great in 10-15 years, and probably easier to reproduce for, you know, manufacturers. Nottingham Forest up next. Oh, it's, you know what? I'm going perfect up. Because the Forest badge has been around for ages. And this is a badge that someone would go to now. They would switch to now if they had some other badge, because it's a nice, it works perfectly on any item. It's clear. It's got enough detail in the trees sort of thing to make it interesting, especially with the two stars. I don't think there's anything to dislike here. I think it's perfect. Oxford United. I hate that ball. I really do. I just hate that. What is there? Is there like a bull in Oxford? No, there isn't. I've been there. There's nothing there. Peterborough. Boring, to be honest, mate. Boring. It works for them, I'm sure, but just feels a bit boring. There's too many letters in Peterborough United Football Club. I feel like you need something else going on there. Plymouth Argyle. Now, I'm unsure about this one, but I do like the green. There's not a lot of green teams, but it does feel a bit dated, the shape of it. You know, I'll put it in fine. I think it's fine. Port Vale. Ugh. No, why did you bother? It's the colour. It's the same as the Newport County badge. I think, and maybe like almost Harrogate. I think it's the colour of it that I just find really upsetting. I am sorry. I think there's too much white and black going on. And I don't like the sort of orange, really desaturated orange being that final colour. Portsmouth. I like it. Do I like it? I love it, you know. I think it's a good badge. Yeah, it's a really good badge. I think that probably feels timeless. It does look like a blue turkey, but, you know, it is what it is. I think if that went straight in the Prem, I think you wouldn't. There would be no changing. That could go global. That could go across the globe. It won't because it's Portsmouth, but it could do if they wanted it to. Preston. I really hate the PP. I really, really hate the PP. It really bothers me. What would you? You can't just have PP on your badge with, what is it, like a lamb? Is that like a lamb on a cross? God, I don't know, but it's really shit. The ribbons just don't, I don't really feel like they've met. It's just a horrible shape. It's so thin, the crest. Ugh, ugh. Queen's Park Rangers, though. Boom. Love it. I thought I wasn't going to like a lot of the Roundel badges. I feel pretty bored of them, but turns out, no. No, I do. I clearly love them. Yeah, the QPR ones really. I like the text in the middle because it's like, oh, but it extends out a little bit. Oh, but not in a cartoonish way like the City badge. Oh, I like it. I think it's nice. Reading as well. I think Reading's really good. I'm off the page now, but I have to put it in perfect up. I think the Reading badge is nice. I like the stripes. I like the contrast with the red. Beautiful. Love it. Feels like Reading. Rochdale up next. And look, it's Peterborough. It's just a bit boring. I think there's too much going on, and I don't really like it. Oh my. Rotherham. Rotherham, Rotherham, Rotherham. I hate the shape. The bit in the middle is pretty cool. I'll take that. Was it a windmill and a ball? Yeah, I like it. With the letters in the windmill. Yes, I like it. But then the outside, the shape just feels so like, it feels so puny. It's annoying. It really does annoy me. What's this? Salford City. I feel like it looks a bit odd on a kit, but I understand why they've done that. But I don't really like the red outline. I'm going to put it in boring. You know, I think there's something about it which I feel like needs to be added or changed, and I'm not a fan. Okay, I think it's the shape that bothers me. I get that it's a line, but I don't know. Sheffield United up next, which is I'm gonna stick it in. I love it. It's got two scimitars, you know, they're not just swords, they look like Middle Eastern swords, and that's fun. That is fun. Sheffield Wednesday. Really ugly. I hate the owl. I'm going to put, why did you bother? I just hate the owl. It's so, that looks, Sheffield United looks so much better than Sheffield Wednesday. I'm sorry, but it does. There's too much, like, I don't know, the drawing of the owl just looks crap. And the S and the W. I don't like it. I'm sorry. Shrewsbury Town, though. Perfect art. Love it. Really love it. Free Lion. Why am I doing the shocker? Free Lions. Yes. Yes, please. I like it. I like the gold. I like the blue. I like the slightly dark blue. I think it's all good by me. I think it's a lovely, I think it's a beautiful badge. Southampton. You know, I love it. It's not perfect, but I love it. There's quite a lot going on there. They're like, oh, we like trees. Oh, we like footballs. Oh, we're also the Saints. Oh, we also have by a river. We're called Southampton. Also, there's a little flower. Also with a stripy red and white striped scarf. you know, there's a lot going on, but I feel like they've actually managed to consolidate all that information quite well. And I don't know, maybe I'm just a bit nostalgic for Southampton's badge because of, they were in the Premier League when I was little as well. And when I'd buy the football stickers, I just thought that badge was pretty interesting. Stevenage. Now, I believe this is a newer badge from Stevenage, because in my head, when I think Stevenage, I think of their old one, which I feel like, for me, is my go-to when I see a coat of arms. I'm like, oh, that's probably Stevenage. I'm going to go fine. Okay, I'll nice you. There's something about it which I'm just like, I get you had to change a coat of arms, but you don't have to make it a circle. I felt like I hoped a bit more from Stevenage, and I don't know why. I have no expectations for Stevenage whatsoever. But I felt like you should have done something more interesting with your badge. And I've got nothing to back that up. Stockport County. Let's just stick you in with these three boys. Yeah, not really having that, mate. Just a bit tired of that one. Stoke City. Art. Love it. I like the shape. I like the blue and the red together. I like the big Stoke and the slightly smaller city. It's got the date. What more could you want? I think it's good. I think it sets well. And I like the graphic design. Sunderland, fantastic. I love it. I hope they never change it. It feels iconic. I think it, because it feels like similar to Newcastle, but not Newcastle. And not in like a, oh my God, how dare you say that. But it's like, they feel like rivals because their sort of badge makeup feels relatively similar, but not exactly the same. I like the storyline of that. So I'm putting perfect art. I think it's a classic. Oh God, who's this? Who is this? Sutton. That's violently ugly, mate. Delete that. That is why. Why did you try and make that? What is that? Really? I'm so sorry, but please. No, that looks like it should be on like the logo of like a posh school or something. Swansea's badge. Now they've returned back to their previous badge. Thank God, because this one I hate. Why did you bother? I believe it was like maybe a remake of an older one they had, but it's just so ugly. I don't like it. I really don't like it. It bothers me. They managed to go to the simplified one. Don't go back. I don't care if it's a throwback. Don't go back. The newer one is perfect for Swansea, and they should keep that one for ages. Oh yeah, now Swindon. No, it just looks flabby and like it's melted. I'm gonna stick it on. Why did you bother? I'm not a fan. You know what? I'm gonna stick it on. Delete your club. Not for me, that one. Tottenham Hotspur. I'm already gonna put it in nice. I think it's, I don't know, it's a bit different. Maybe just because it feels a bit more iconic, or it feels very Spurs now. You know what I mean? But it is like some crappy bird on a basketball, which sort of detracts from it. But it feels very them, and I think it works. I like that it's a different shape on this occasion. I think, apart from the Salford one, I think you're pretty good going if you just have like the shape of the animal sort of thing. Who is this? Who the fuck is that? Right, actually, I've got no idea who this is, but I'm going to stick it in. Delete your club. It's really, there's too much going on. The amount of colours, it's like, oh, let's put the most amount of bright colours we possibly can on our badge. There's just far too much going on, and it is violently ugly. Walsall, boring. Too flat, you know, just too flat. It's a bit like Brighton, who are up there, but I don't know what it is. It feels even less than that. I think because there's only writing over here, and it feels like there's just so many more gaps around the edge. Not for me, that one. Watford, I hate the colour scheme, but the badge is okay. Is it a moose? Why are they called the Hornets? Why is it not a hornet? Is that a moose? Is there meese in Watford? I don't think there is. Or is it deer? What is it? It's a red deer, apparently. I'm not convinced. It looks like a moose. West Brom up next, and I think it's nice. Yeah, I think it's nice. I think it does a job. I think it's a good balance of colours. And the bird sort of works that it's in colour sitting on a little green leaf. Because the other colours feel relatively neutral. So I like it. I like it. West Ham. Boring. Boring, boring, boring. That one really bothers me. That they had a good badge before, I liked it. Then they changed to West Ham United London. And there's so much extra space in the badge, just of nothing. It just feels unbalanced. I don't like it. And I'm sorry, West Ham, but you could do so much better than that. You really could. It was a really poor design change from them. Wigan. I'll stick this in nice. You know what? I think it's a nice badge. It's got a crown. It's got a tree. Feels pretty, it's pretty obvious it's Wigan. I think it's a nice. Wolves, a Hampton Wanderers. My arch nemesis. Oh, it's clean, it's simple, but I'm sticking it in boring, my friend. I don't know. I'm just not a fan of it. I just think it feels like there's something missing from it. Maybe a bit of a date, or I don't know. But to be fair, they've had it for ages. I think if it had some stars, that'd be good. Like the Nottingham Forest badge. If it had some stars above it, I think it would work. But it doesn't, because they haven't won two European Cups. So it is what it is. No stars, mate. Just put some decorative ones up there. I love those. I love the decorative ones. Newcastle, that's got to go up in. That has got to go up in perfect art. I like it. Two seahorses. What's that got to do with football? Fuck all, mate. But, you know, they're near a river and the ocean, I guess. So why not? That's where seahorses are from. I don't think they should ever change a badge. Same with Sunderland. Look at them next to each other. Oh, it's just similar. They're both, like, working up to, like, a little, like, spire sort of thing. Both got, like, the badge and the stripe in the middle. Both got the ribbon at the bottom. And then both have two animals climbing to the top. What's not to love? It's good. It's just good. It's really good. Really good fun, that. Finally, we've got Wickham Wanderers with some sort of... Is that a geese? Or is that a swan? Either way, I don't know the difference between a goose and a swan. But regardless, irritating animals. And I don't know why you'd want to be represented by them. Bastards. Bastards of the local rivers. I'm sticking you in... Oh, it's actually in fine, to be honest. I'm not that annoyed about it. It's inoffensive enough, and it feels like Wickham. There's a bit extra space in there. Maybe put the date on the left and the right, and you'd be golden. But they didn't do that because they didn't listen to me, because I am a genius. Right, here is my massive list of all 92 club badges. I've been your boy, Kieran. Let me know if you agree or disagree with me in the comments down below. Don't forget to join the club. Become a supporter of CCFC, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.